Presence, ladies and gentlemen of the media. I thank President Michel Aoun, Speaker of Parliament Nabi Berri, Prime Minister Najib Mikati, the Government of Lebanon, and the Lebanese people for their warm welcome. I'm grateful not only for the possibility to engage with the political and military authorities in important discussions about the future of Lebanon, but also with religious leaders, several groups of representatives of the civil society, women activists, and youth. It has been an honor for me to visit Lebanon once again. But it grieves me to see the people of this beautiful country suffering so much. The people of Lebanon face immense challenges. Yet, despite the strains they endure, the warmth and generosity of the Lebanese people continues to shine. The region and the world remain thankful for Lebanon's generosity in giving refuge to people fleeing violent conflict abroad. And I first witnessed this as High Commissioner for Refugees, and I felt it again these past 2 days in conversations with Lebanese people from all walks of life. I commend Lebanon's spirit of coexistence and tolerance. Ladies and gentlemen, while here, I visited the Beirut port. My thoughts are with the victims of the devastating blast that took the precious lives of more than 200 people, parents, daughters, sons, friends and colleagues from over a dozen countries. The United Nations mourns with you. 2 children of UN staff members were among the youngest victims. The Lebanese people and the families of all the victims deserve answers and justice that can only be met through impartial, thorough and transparent investigation. I am also gravely concerned about the impact of the economic and financial crisis in the country, causing ever more people to need humanitarian assistance. Yesterday, I visited Tripoli in North Lebanon and today Tyre in the south. And I was very moved when listening to first-hand testimonies about the crisis is impacting people's daily lives. People expect their political leaders to listen to their needs and to restore the economy, including through a functioning government and state institutions and by effectively fighting corruption. These past 2 days, I have urged Lebanon's political leaders to work to implement reforms that respond to the demands of the Lebanese people for greater welfare, accountability, protection, and transparency in order to restore hope for a better future. I've underlined the need to allow for the swift start of the formal negotiations to finalize the agreement with the IMF without further impediments. Seeing the suffering of the people of Lebanon, Lebanese leaders do not have the right to be divided and paralyze the country. All government institutions are measured on results: social protection, access to electricity and water, education and basic health care, good governance, and the protection of human rights. In charting a path towards sustainable recovery, civil society, women and young people have a critical role to play. Their voices must be heard and their proposals seriously considered. Free and fair parliamentary elections held on time in 2022 will be an essential opportunity for the people to make their voices heard. The announcement of the President of the Republic after our meeting that the elections will be held in early May, confirmed in my meetings with the Prime Minister and the President of the Parliament, represents an important guarantee that the Constitution will be respected. and the meaningful participation of women will be essential. As part of our commitment to Lebanon's stability, I visited UNIFIL in southern Lebanon. Commitment to the full implementation of Resolution 1701 and maintaining the cessation of hostilities across the Blue Line and decreasing tensions between the parties is crucial. The rockets fired from Lebanese territory and the response from Israel earlier this year are reminders of the dangers to international peace and security. A miscalculation or misunderstanding could have profound consequences. Violations are also unacceptable. UNIFIL also needs full and unimpeded access throughout its area of operations. I take this opportunity to salute the thousands of women and men peacekeepers who are far from their families and countries serving peace in Lebanon. And I'd like to stress that continued international support to the Lebanese armed forces is essential for the stability in Lebanon. I encourage all member states to continue and, more important, to increase that support. The United Nations, with the international community, including through the International Support Group, remains committed to helping promote a sustainable recovery and an inclusive and dignified future for Lebanon and its people in full respect of human rights. The international community must be ready to substantially increase its solidarity with Lebanon in the implementation of the needed reforms to stabilize the economy and address the basic needs of the Lebanese people. Let's not forget that the UN Humanitarian Response Plan is only 11% funded despite the dramatic situation of the Lebanese people and the Lebanese economy. Let me close by once again asking the political leaders to resolve the crisis and the international community to come forward, strengthening its support for Lebanon. Thank you. And I'm naturally at your